Now we will see the properties of the alkyl halides, the chemical properties. What are the reactions that alkyl halide take place and they give rise to these compounds which contain this functional group? Now alkyl halides, if I see, this is polar compound, so this bond can be easily cleaved and this halide can be easily substituted, and this will give rise to a carbocation and halide can be removed or replaced, and one nucleophile can come and attack this carbocation. So the type of reaction that alkyl halides mainly take place, they are nucleophilic substitution. So any nucleophile can come and substitute the halide group. Now this nucleophilic substitution can be of two types. It can take place in two ways. One is SN1, another one is SN2 mechanism. So the nucleophile can follow the SN1 pathway or SN2 pathway depending on the type of the substrate or the carbocation that is present, that will be formed. Now in case of SN1 reaction, the foremost criteria that must be present is the formation of carbocation in the intermediate. Formation of carbocation in the intermediate. So this takes place in two steps. And why this is one? Because it depends only on the concentration of the attacking or one of the substrate. Okay? The rate of the reaction depends upon the concentration of the substrate. So, rate of the reaction, concentration of the substrate. It does not depend on the attacking reagent. So how does this look like? This SN1 mechanism, suppose if I take CH3, CH2, Cl. If it follows FN1 mechanism, this chloride will be cleaved. This chlorine will leave the molecule and this will form a carbocation. So this has formed a carbocation, a primary carbocation. Now the nucleophile, this is the first step. This is the first step. The second step is that the nucleophile will come and attack this carbocation and will replace the chlorine. So you see, the configuration of this molecule is maintained in the product also. In the parent molecule, whatever the configuration it was retained in the product molecule as well. So, another property of SN1 is that retention of configuration. Retention of configuration. So, it retains the original configuration of the reactant molecule. Clear? And it depends on the rate of the reaction depends on the the substrate where this will form the carbocation. So this is the rate determining step. Clear? So that's why this is one. So the rate depends only one of the molecule, not on both substrate as well as attacking reagent, which occurs in SN2. Now this pathway is favored if the alkyl halide is either secondary or tertiary, or if the alkyl halide rearranges or the intermediate rearranges to form a tertiary carbocation. In that case, this SN1 mechanism pathway will be followed by the molecule. Otherwise, SN2 is followed in most of the cases. So in SN1, so let me give you an example. So let's take an example. SN1 mechanism, because the first step is the rate determining step where the carbocation formation will take place. So this is the carbocation formation, and this will be favored because this is 2 degree carbocation. Next, the nucleophile will come and attack this carbocation and it will form the product. So in case of this tertiary or secondary alkyl halide, SN1 mechanism is favored over SN2 mechanism. Why? That we will see now. Case of SN2 mechanism, this 2 is present because the rate of the reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of the substrate, which is the alkyl halide, as well as the attacking reagent, the nucleophile that is attacking. So this is the first difference between SN1 and SN2. In SN1, the rate was directly proportional to the alkyl halide or the substrate. Because this alkyl halide will form the carbocation, and that step is the rate determining step. So this always proceeds through the formation of carbocations. So this is the most important thing that we need to understand. Now in case of SN2, there is no such intermediate that is formed. So it takes place in a single step. In one step reaction. How is this taking place? Suppose this is the substrate. I am taking it to be S. Okay. Or the alkyl halide. X. Now the nucleophile will come and try to substitute this alkyl halide. That's why it will form a new bond and a new product. So the nucleophile in case of SN2 will attack the carbocation or the carbon which is attached to the halide group from the back side. So this will attack from the back side of the alkyl halide. So this will lead to a formation of a transition state where the nucleophile will start forming a bond with the carbon atom which is attached to the halide group, and this bond will be weakened. So this is the transition state that the molecule will undergo, and finally this bond will be totally cleaved and the new product will be formed, and the new product is formed. So you see, the nucleophile is present just in the opposite position to that of halide. So, inversion of configuration takes place in case of SN2 mechanism. So, in case of SN2 mechanism, the product that is formed is inverted in configuration to that of the alkyl halide. Okay? So, this takes place via inversion of configuration. And the most important point that we need to know is that the nucleophile attacks the carbon or the alkyl group from the backside. So this is very important. Backside attack takes place. So it attacks that carbon atom which is attached to the halide group. Now you see, when there is tertiary groups present in the alkyl halide, if tertiary group is present, so it is not possible for the nucleophile to go and reach to that particular carbon atom which is attached to the halide group. Thus, in case of alkyl halides which are tertiary or secondary in nature, rather which is sterically hindered, where there is steric crowding, in that case SN2 mechanism will not be followed. So let's take an example. So suppose if I am taking this type of a molecule, an alkyl halide like this, which is tertiary. In that case, the nucleophile will not find any space to go and meet this carbon atom. Okay, it will not be able to reach to this carbon atom which is holding this chlorine. So backside attack is hindered. First thing, and this molecule will try to follow SN1 mechanism, because if it follows XN1 mechanism, so this is SN2 mechanism, if it follows, it cannot follow the SN2 mechanism because it is sterically hindered from three sides. So it cannot go and attack this carbon atom. Now, this molecule will try to follow SN1 mechanism, because if it follows SN1 mechanism, it can form this can form a carbocation which is tertiary, and this is the most stable carbocation. So this will try to follow SN1 mechanism, because in SN2 mechanism backside attack is hindered and the carbocation that is formed will be very stable. So the molecule will try to follow the pathway of SN1 rather than SN2 mechanism. And one more thing is that here retention of configuration will take place, inversion will take place. In case of SN2 mechanism, the rate of the reaction depends both on the substrate as well as the attacking reagent. That's why it's 2. So, because the transition that state that is formed in case of SN2 will depend upon this, where bond making and bond breaking will take place simultaneously. So, the rate will depend both on this alkyl halide as well as this nucleophile, because nucleophile will form the bond and this bond will be broken. So it has to be dependent both on the concentration of these two. That's why it's 2 written. And the inversion of configuration will take place in case of the molecule follows the pathway of SN2 mechanism. But in case of SN1 mechanism, retention of the configuration will take place, and most importantly, it occurs through carbocation intermediate. But there is no intermediate that is formed, only the transition state is formed, and the rate will depend only on this. So this is all about the SN1 and XN2 mechanism, how the alkyl halide can undergo substitution reaction. Now we will see what are the reactions and what are the products that the alkyl halide give rise to by this substitution method.